What's up, guys? GameNut here, and welcome back to now week number 3 of our predictions of the NFL season. We didn't do too bad last week. You know, we improved from week 1. That's all I have to say. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at our picks as well as Madden 19, see how things are matching up right now in terms of our record. So you guys can see right here with all the checks and the X's, we broke even. We got 8 right, we got 8 wrong. I mean, again, technically we had ourselves another tie in the NFL, which is pretty weird. I know some people would consider that just a tie in the record for, you know, when you're predicting games like this, but for me, I'm just going to go ahead and count it as a loss. I mean, obviously I know there's no really a way that we can predict a tie. I mean, obviously we can guess, but there's just like a long shot, but regardless, we're going to count it as a loss. But like I said, we went 8-8 with our picks, and Madden 19, once we simulated all the games, as well as you guys know, they did a little bit better than us. They had one game more correct than we did. They had 9 picks correctly, and they had 7 wrong. So the final total right now after week 2, we are currently sitting with a 15-17 record. They are sitting with a 17-15 record. So, you know, not too far behind, but, you know, we definitely have room to improve here. Last week we had ourselves another great week of football. You know, I guess technically any week of football is great football, obviously, but you know, we've got ourselves another week here, week number 3, another slew of 16 games, and we're starting things off with Thursday night football. We have the Jets going to take on the winless Browns. Well, I shouldn't say winless anymore, because after, I think, what was it, 635 days or something like that, the Browns finally got their first victory in forever, man. So now they are sitting with a record of 1-1-1. Yeah, that's you don't see that too often, but the Browns did it, man. Congrats to them. I'm happy for them. They got themselves that victory. Baker Mayfield was able to come in and get it done. Now, you guys can see my tweet on screen. I did end up choosing the Jets. Yeah, so Thursday night football, I thought the Jets were going to be able to get it done. Now, granted, hear me out on this for a second here. So I chose the Jets to win this game, right? However, if I knew that Baker Mayfield was going to have an impact on this game or play whatsoever, you know, going into this game, you figure Tyrod's going to play the entire thing. You don't think that he gets, you know, injured, which I don't know if there was actually like a full technical injury that Tyrod had. I never really, like, you know, followed up on it or anything like that. So I don't know if they just benched Tyrod or if he actually did get injured. But regardless, if I had known that Baker was going to be coming into that game, I would have chose the Browns 100%. So I, you know, I got a little bit robbed here. I would have taken the Browns had I known Baker was going to play. But like I said, I did choose the Jets. So, you know, so far we are 0-3 on our Thursday night football picks to start off the year, man. Definitely not too good. But, you know, like I said, congrats to the Browns, man. They got their first win. It definitely has to feel pretty good. It's like they just literally won the Super Bowl in Cleveland. But anyways, time to go ahead and move on with our next set of picks. So first game that we have for Sunday is going to be the Saints going to take on the Falcons. We got a good divisional game. When these two teams play, it's always pretty intense and a good game. And I think I'm going to have to go with the home team here. We are going to go with the Atlanta Falcons. This is the third time in a row that I picked them. I was wrong the first week. I was right the second week. I think I'll be able to go ahead and get myself a victory here and go 2-1 with the Falcons. I think the Saints, their slow start to the season is going to continue just one more week. They'll bounce back after that, but I'm going to go with the Falcons for now. Aaron Rodgers and his Packers have a 1-0-1 record. They are going to take on the Washington Redskins sitting at 1-1. And, you know, even though A-Rod, man, he's banged up, he's got that sprained MCL, he's going to an away stadium, he's always played pretty good against the Redskins, and they've always turned out to be pretty good games. And I'm going to go with my guy Aaron Rodgers once again. I mean, I can't bet against Aaron Rodgers, dude. Like, I do still think that even though he's a little injured right now, I think he's going to have an MVP-type season. Like, I think he'll be okay with this injury. He's going to eventually get through it. Once he hits that bye week, that's when, you know, he's going to be able to, like, I wouldn't say fully recover, but be good enough to the point where he's not really going to have to worry about it too much. I don't think he's really going to get hit there at any point. But again, like I said, I think Aaron Rodgers is going to have MVP type season. So I'm going to be going with A-Rod once again. He is going to get the win against the Redskins. We have the Colts going to take on the champs, the Eagles. Both of these teams are sitting at 1-1. And I think this one's kind of a no-brainer, guys, right? I mean, I'm going with the Eagles here. I'm going with the defending champs. They're playing at home. I think they're going to bounce back after taking that loss last week to the Buccaneers, which was still crazy, man. Fitzmagic, that dude is insane right now. If you say you predicted Fitzmagic right now to go 2-0, you're completely lying to yourself. But anyways, regardless, I couldn't believe that the Eagles lost last week. That was absolutely crazy. But I think they'll bounce back this week. Andrew Luck, I just still don't see it in him. I just don't think that he's like Andrew Luck, like when he was first coming into the league after this injury. And I think the Eagles will win this game. After that, we have the 0-2 Bills going to take on the Minnesota Vikings, and this is, once again, a no-brainer. There's no question here that you can argue the Bills have a chance to win this game. The Vikings are 100% winning this game. If they don't, I'll do a face reveal, okay? Like, I'm that confident. If the Bills win this game, dude, there's no way it's going to happen. There is no chance Josh Allen beats that Vikings defense at home. I'm sorry, it's just not happening. Vikings going to win this game. This is a matchup that we usually always get every year, and I'm not sure why they like scheduling this game. We've got the Raiders taking on the Dolphins, and I'm hoping my guy Beast Mode is going to show out here, because in the past couple of years when they have played, well, I shouldn't say past couple of years, specifically last year when the Raiders played the Dolphins, Marshawn had a pretty good game, and I'm hoping that's going to happen here once again. I don't see the Dolphins going 3-0. The Raiders, they have to turn their season around at some point. I don't see them falling to 0-3 under the, you know, the John Gruden era, you know, once he's coming back as the new head coach. So I think we're going to have to go Raiders here. They are going to get their first win of the season. Next game, there's no explanation for this. I don't need to say anything. It's the Broncos taking on my Ravens, okay? We know who's getting the win here. But no, in all seriousness, my Ravens, they sucked it up last week. There's no doubt about that. But, you know, playing home against Case Keenum, I just don't think that he's going to be able to do really anything against our defense. At least I hope so, man. I do think, however, that we are going to have a bounce back week, and the Ravens, we are going to go ahead and get that victory. We are going to be a 2-1 team after week 3. Speaking of, you know, my Ravens, the team that just smacked us around, we've got the Bengals going to take on the Panthers. They are 2-0. The Panthers are 1-1. I feel like I see the Panthers defending their home stadium here. I don't see the Bengals going 3-0. If they do, you know, I'll be pretty surprised. You know, I'll give them a round of applause. But I think Cam Newton is going to be able to get it done here. They are going to come out on top. We got the Giants taking on the Texans. Both of these teams are winless. They're sitting at 0-2 going into this week. Obviously, you know, I wouldn't say that this was expected for both of these teams to start off 0-2. I definitely wouldn't say that. But I don't really know which of these teams is going to start off 0-3. Like, you could argue a case for both of these teams, but you know what? I think I'm going to go Giants here. I think that Eli and Saquon, they're going to start getting things going here, and they're going to start off, and they're going to get the victory here. They're going to get their first one of the season, and I think the struggles with Deshaun Watson are going to continue. Because, I mean, I don't know, man, it's just kind of crazy. Like, I guess, you know, that knee injury seriously affected Deshaun Watson, because he's not playing like Deshaun Watson of last year, man, and I don't see it yet. So I think I'm going to have to go Giants here. This is a no-brainer, man. Just, there's no question about it. A divisional game here. We've got the Titans going to take on those Jaguars. Jags are going 3-0. No question about it. Moving on. Jimmy G and his Niners going to take on the boy, Patrick Mahomes. That dude is on fire. 10 touchdowns through the first two games of the season. My God, dude. Patrick Mahomes, that boy's crazy. He is an absolute stud, okay? I'm not going to lie. You know, when I made my first predictions for the first week, if you guys want to go back to that video, I definitely did say I don't see Patrick Mahomes putting up like Deshaun Watson type numbers of what he did last year. I did say that, and obviously I'm biting my words here, because that was a complete lie. He's doing better than what Deshaun Watson did last year, man. Dude, Patrick Mahomes is crazy. I'm still on the bus of him. That offense is wild. It is overpowered. It is so explosive. Chiefs are going to definitely be getting the win here at home, going 3-0. The battle of the LA teams. We've got the Chargers taking on the Rams. Now, I do think the Chargers are a pretty decent team, but going to take on the Rams in their stadium with just how good that offense and especially that defense is, I don't see them getting it done. I think the Rams will definitely get themselves that win here. This is another one of those games that they usually match up every single year, and it's just like, why do we want to always see the Cowboys playing the Seahawks? I don't know why, but we've got 1-1 Cowboys traveling to Seattle, 0-2. And I think I'm going to go Seattle here once again. You know, I keep choosing Seattle to pick every single week, and I've been wrong both times. They keep letting me down, man. I mean, their offensive line is just absolutely pathetic. I mean, watching that game against the Bears, it's like, how do any of those guys still have starting jobs? Like, the offensive line of Seattle is terrible. Like, I feel so bad for Russell Wilson, but I do think that they're going to get their first win of the season here. This is their first home game of the year. I think they're not going to let that crowd down. I think they'll get the win, and plus, I don't think the Cowboys are really all that good, honestly, and I think Seahawks will get the win. We've got the Bears taking on the Cardinals, and you know what? I'm done playing against the Bears, man, okay? I'm all in on Chicago. That defense is a little bit ridiculous, okay, with Khalil Mack. He's seriously, like, he's devastating. He is just causing so much destruction. I'm going to be going ahead taking the Bears in this game. Plus, they are playing the Cardinals, granted. I mean, they're just, like, what are they doing? 0-2. David Johnson, like, do they remember that they have David Johnson on their team? I mean, they just haven't been giving that dude the ball whatsoever. Their team sucks. Just start Josh Rosen already. The Bears are going to be getting the win. Sunday Night Football. We've got the Patriots going to take on the Lions. Why do the Lions have another primetime game? I don't know why. Don't ask me. I didn't schedule these games for the NFL, but we've got Tom Brady traveling to Detroit, and definitely Tom Brady's getting the win here. There's no doubt about that. I mean, the Lions, man, it's kind of crazy to see. Like, I definitely didn't expect them to be this bad. Now, granted, they definitely did a lot better last week than they did the first game of the season. There's no question about that. But it's possible we could see ourselves like another repeat of week one where the Lions just get destroyed at their home stadium in primetime. I don't know. I mean, it is Tom Brady. If Sam Darnold did it at their home stadium in primetime, what's Tom Brady going to do? I mean, come on now. I think the Patriots obviously are easily going to get the win. And last but not least, we've got our Monday Night Football game. The Pittsburgh Steelers going to take on Fitzmagic and the Buccaneers. Dude, first of all, Fitzmagic, what a guy. Like, what a guy. Like, what a season he is having so far. Taking the Bucs 2-0. I mean, congrats to him, man. GG's. Like, I don't think he's going to continue, however. I mean, obviously, the Bucs aren't going to keep getting wins. They're going to lose at some point. But they're going to get another win here on Monday Night Football. They're going to go 3-0. The Steelers are going to go 0-2-1. Their struggles are going to continue. Antonio Brown wants to be traded. Ben Roethlisberger is always hurt. Le'Veon Bell is still crying home on his couch, wanting to be paid like he's a billionaire or something like that. But the Buccaneers, they're going to get themselves that win again, and they are going to go 3-0, I think. And there you guys have it. There are my picks for week 3 of the NFL. I'm definitely feeling a little bit more confident this week with my picks. Like, I'm kind of thinking I'm going to get like at least 10 or 11 right. I think we're definitely going to do definitely pretty good this week. I don't know. I just have like a good intuition about it. But of course, now comes that interesting time where we have to see what Madden 19 decided to choose as their predictions of who is going to win in week number 3. Now, last week was crazy. We were almost identical with our picks. We picked every game exactly the same except for 3 games. That was it. It was kind of wild. However, this week, a little bit of a different story, so let's go ahead and jump straight into it. So obviously our first game of the week was Thursday Night Football. We already know what happened. Once I just simulated the games on Madden 19, they did choose the Browns to win. So, you know, of course, EA, Madden 19, whatever, they're always picking the stupid Thursday Night games correctly and whatnot, so they're starting off good. We've got our next 2 games here the exact same. So they also chose the Falcons, and they also chose the Packers to get the win here. So next game, we've got the Eagles and Colts. They chose the Colts to win this game, going to the Eagles Stadium, the defending champs, after just taking a loss to the Buccaneers. They got the Colts winning. Don't know if I agree with it, obviously, but you know, it's what they chose. Okay, we're going to move on. We've got the Bills and Vikings. They chose the Bills. Are you kidding me? That just shows how broke this game is. Madden 19 seriously chose the Bills to beat the Vikings. Are you kidding me? Okay, anyways, we're going to move on and ignore that. Obviously, Madden just took an L right there. We've got the Raiders and Dolphins. They also chose the Raiders to win. They took another L here. Okay, they're choosing the Broncos against my own team. Obviously, they're incorrect there. They also went with the Bengals instead of the Panthers. They went with the Texans instead of the Giants. The next 3 picks, however, we are exactly the same. We all chose the Jaguars, Chiefs, and Rams. Obviously, we're kind of on the same page there with which teams are better in those games. And then we went completely opposite on the final 4 games of the week. They chose the Cowboys, the Cardinals, the Lions, and the Steelers. That's crazy, man. They think the Cardinals are going to be able to beat the Bears. They think the Lions at home are going to be able to beat the Patriots, which, by the way, you guys will see in just a second when I show you guys the simulated games and the scores. Just wait till you see the scores. Just look a little bit closer, especially once you see that Patriots and Lions game. Look what they predicted to happen. And then last but not least, they did also choose the Steelers to get their first win of the season. So there you guys have it, man. That is the week 3 predictions for me and Madden 19. I think we could definitely pull ahead here with our record. You know, we're negative right now, 15-17. They're sitting at 17-15. I think after this week, we're going to be ahead of Madden 19. I definitely feel like that's a possibility. So hopefully all of you guys enjoyed, man. Of course, here is all of the guesses or all of the scores of the games that were simulated for Madden 19 to show you guys. Those are the teams that they picked. But hopefully all of you guys enjoyed, man. Enjoy some football today. I will catch you guys all in the next one. Take it easy, guys. Peace out.